there's trials and tribulations, next 4 years throughout the Naval Academy, just like you're doing right now. Graduated, became an outstanding Marine Corps infantry officer. All of his enlisted men I've ever met praise highly that they love him, like you love each other. Served, was awarded the Silver Star in combat. You can read his citation, all you have to do is hit the Google machine. He is all over the place. Now, what he is doing, he's continuing to serve his fellow brethren, the military, in the United States of America to make this a better place. Just like Coach told you, what your future is, whenever you come here, is to not only be a good person, good football player, he's going to mold you into a career, a life of service, whether it's a lawyer, whether it's a CEO, just like Brian is, whether he's getting jobs for people in the military, just like Brian is. And most importantly, what we all have talked about, he's a father of some beautiful girls. Brian Stann. Oh, one more. UFC champion.
Bryce, thank you so much. When you said you were going to let Bryce do some introduction, I thought he was going in a completely different direction than he did. Bryce, you went easy on me, buddy. Thank you. Thank you. Hey, guys, real pleasure. It's an honor to come back and talk to you guys. And like I said, we're all cut from the same mold. You know, I walked the same shoes that you guys walked. I definitely was not as athletic, though, as I watched that field. So while I still think I could whoop each and every one of you, I definitely can't beat anybody in the court. But what you guys have been able to do here since my time and since I left is incredible. And I can't commend this football coaching staff enough because I was able to witness it after I graduated. You know, everybody can see on TV that we're producing a better football. Everybody sees that. The wins and losses, the bowl game, everything, it's outstanding. But what I saw in the Marine Corps was, forget about just the football season. We're producing a far better military officer as a whole from this team than we did prior to the staff. And I mean that. That's the most important. You know, you hear about the football, and I know you guys got a lot of goals on the field. More importantly than that, one day you will go on and you're going to lead large groups of men and women and they're going to depend on you. And not every one of you is going to go into combat like myself and like Bryce. But when you look at the statistics, it'll open your eyes and you'll realize that we lose just about as many service men and women to suicide and transportation accidents as we do in combat. So each one of you is going to have influence over somebody and you will make life and death decisions at some point or another. Even if it's just something small as noticing that one of your sailors and Marines was a little off that day, you put a little bit of extra leadership time to check in on them and make sure that everything's all right. Those little things can go a long way. The most important thing I want to talk to you about today is that attitude, in my opinion, and I strongly believe that, is the first reflection of your character, who you are as a human being. And it is not easy at this institution to wake up every day and have a real positive attitude. I get that. I understand it. But attitude is the biggest common denominator I see in my life of highly successful people. Everybody that I know whose life continues to do this have great attitudes. Gotta wake up early to go on a flight. Doesn't matter, they're gonna smile about it. Got a whole lot of work today. Gotta sign something last minute. That's fine, I'll deal with it. Man, we gotta go to practice or our leave got canceled or I got my leave denied or I can't have my weekend this weekend. Got it, great attitude. Guys that I played ball with here and that I went to school with here that had the so-so attitude, you know, didn't really care about following all the rules and regulations. They ducked out of a lot, didn't want to hit the weight room that hard. They came out to practice pretty often and they went through the motions, they got it done, but they weren't the guys that were grinding for that extra inch every day. I got news for you guys. You don't throw your hat up on graduation day and then it lands and this magic cloud of smoke hits and you just become awesome. That mediocre attitude they had continued with them. They were mediocre officers. Guess what? They got out of the military, mediocre at that too. And they lived mediocre lives. There's no way any of you signed that piece of paper when you decided to come to this school knowing what you were going to get into because you wanted to be mediocre. None of you. I want you to think about that. When you guys wake up every day, let the effort I just saw in that field and that you guys put in the weight room, everything you do in the locker room, let it bleed into every aspect of your life. Because I know that there is sometimes a disconnect between the football players and the rest of the game. But you know what's crazy about combat? Is all that BS goes away. In combat, it doesn't matter where you went to school. It doesn't matter what company you're in. It doesn't matter whether you play ball or not. It doesn't matter what color your skin is. It doesn't matter what kind of girls you like. It doesn't matter what kind of music you listen to. Everybody's equal and everybody gets along. So make sure that you guys continue that same positive attitude towards everybody that you're going to meet. Because you never know who you may go to battle with. You never know who you may operate with depending on what you do when you get out of this institution. You never know who you may have to put your life in their hands and vice versa. So keep that open mind. But remember, each and every day, that success doesn't just magically happen for people. I wish some of my classmates that stood on the same field as me, I wish I could go back in time and wake them up. Say, hey, Chad, hey, Brett, hey, Johnny, you're slacking today. You know, you slack a little bit every day. Everybody sees it, and your attitude towards it is, hey, you're not cool if you're going to tell me about it. You don't want to hear the truth. And I want to tell them that it will affect them later in life. Because now I look at them, and they're the ones calling me, asking me, hey, yeah, man, you know, I'm really unhappy in this situation. I'm living in this city. I got this crappy dead-end job, and, you know, my time in the Navy didn't go so well, so I got out and I went and did this or that. And you see it happen. And you would have known it would have happened on the field as well. You guys know. I bet you right now, if I asked you right here, I said, hey, point to me five guys that you guarantee will be successful past this place. You'll point to all five. You'll say, man, these guys, every day in the weight room, every day in the film room, every day in the classroom, everything they do has a certain standard of excellence to it. And I promise you, if you guys develop that here, your leadership will know no bounds. There is no greater leadership institution than these service academies and then the military themselves as officers. I've worked with men and women who have graduated with business degrees from Harvard, Yale, name all those really prestigious institutions. And they're really bright people. Don't get me wrong, they are. But in terms of taking that intelligence, combining it with the skills necessary for leadership to take a group of people and make them be able to accomplish more together than they would be individually, they will not have those skills. You will have years of practice. By the age of 24, you will lead units over 40 people. In the civilian world, you're a leader if you're in charge of two. It's incredible. And the accountability, you could not imagine how much more accountable you guys are right now on this field, in that hall, than your peers at other schools. And the military is very similar to this field, where you guys demand excellence of one another. Hey, you didn't do your assignment because you didn't do that. That guy blew past the gap, made me look bad too. Same thing when you're in the military, guys. Same thing as you train your Marines and your sailors to do everything correct. Not just do it well, you want them to do it perfect. That same standard you guys hold yourself now, and again, it all goes back to your attitude. Because if you wake up one morning and your attitude is, just going to get it done today, we all know what happens. Any games where you guys kind of just got it done and just kind of went through the motions last year and you guys know you could have won, but they slipped out of your hands, and you know that feeling when you're in the locker room, it just didn't feel right. It's the same way in life. To be really real and raw with you guys, it could be like this. You know, I've had the unfortunate experience of having to carry people that I love, that I truly cherish, off that battlefield. And I can tell you, it's not a good feeling. And it will cost you some sleepless nights, but it's what we all signed up for. And if you start doing everything to a standard of excellence now, you're going to do everything right that you can to prevent that from happening. You're not always going to pitch a shutout in combat, right? The enemy scores points sometimes too. But if you're prepared and you do everything you can to prepare yourself and your team to execute, you can minimize those risks. And you can minimize the amount of times that you may have to pull one of your men or women off that battlefield. And you can save those lives. And you're going to have influence over hundreds of sailors and Marines. These young men and women, they don't come from the backgrounds that all of us, some of them will, some of some of you guys come from those backgrounds, but the men and women who enlist in our armed forces generally come from very tough backgrounds. You enlist in the military during a time of war, chances are your parents weren't making six figures a year and you came from a white collar area. They need guidance, they came to be a part of something. And they came looking and searching for leaders like you. Don't take that for granted, guys. Make sure that your attitude every day, on this field, in that hall, in the classroom, is with the standard of excellence. And I guarantee if you do that, I guarantee you, you will succeed. Not one of my friends from this institution that had that kind of attitude is struggling right now. They're not struggling for happiness, their families are great, and they're not struggling in their bank account either. And their careers are doing very, very well. And it all has one common denominator, and that's that attitude of excellence.
All right, fellas, hey, let's make this one loud for me, all right? Hey, for all those who came before us and those who are going to come after, so that brotherhood tradition lives on forever. Ready? One, two, three, brotherhood!